existing evidence suggests that even when there's evidence of aneuploidy, abnormal chromosomal counts in these embryos, if you go back and re-biopsy the embryo, as much as almost a quarter of the time, the second biopsy won't agree with the first. So there's variety in these embryos. And we believe that some of that variety can lead to a healthy baby in spite of an abnormal diagnosis. On that basis, we've recently begun in special circumstances in people who have maybe gone through biopsies at other centers and been told all their embryos were abnormal, but they were frozen. We've gone ahead and transferred embryos even when they're abnormal. We've been doing this actually for some time using earlier techniques. We transferred embryos when there appeared to be monosomies, and that's because if the monosomy was true, the embryo wouldn't survive. So you're not worried about ending up with an abnormal baby, you're just not going to have implantation. But if the monosomy is actually not representative of reality, then the baby has a chance of surviving. And especially using older techniques in which it was harder to read monosomies, this seemed like a viable way to proceed. And we've had three people who've gone on to have normal pregnancies after having such embryos transferred. So we're carrying that forward into the more modern techniques and beginning to ask questions about whether even with the new trophectoderm biopsy and the quantitative PCRs that people are doing, which are very precise for the cells tested, might there still be some room in there based on what we call mosaicism, meaning the variety of chromosomal identities within the different cells, to still have a normal baby.